Finally, let's look at the frequency bands. Actually, we've talked about the most important resource in mobile communication, or the most important resource in wireless communication, is our spectrum resource. The spectrum resources we are going to use in the 5G era mainly focus on the C-band from 3 GHz to 6 GHz, including our millimeter wave band, because the bands below 3 GHz have actually been allocated to 2G, 3G and 4G. So below 3 GHz, the available continuous spectrum resources are relatively few. So our main spectrum resources in the 5G era will be in the C-band, that is from 3 GHz to 6 GHz. Then this section will be the most important band for 5G coverage and capacity. Of course, in some hotspot areas, or if we need to use some of these 5G small base stations for self-backhaul, then we can also consider using millimeter waves. For example, using 28 GHz millimeter waves, 39 GHz millimeter waves. To provide some capacity supplementation in hotspot areas, this is all possible. As for the 5G band, we mainly focus on these two areas. There is also below 3 GHz, but its resources are very limited. So it won't be the main band, because other bands are mainly given to 2G, 3G, 4G. So the main focus is on the C band, that is from 3 GHz to 6 GHz. Similarly, millimeter waves will become an effective supplement to our capacity. Actually, we can also take a look at this. The current global situation of C-band and high-frequency millimeter waves, take the United States as an example. The United States may mainly be able to get the millimeter wave band because their C-band, that is the resources in the C-band, many resources have been occupied by the US military. So in the future, the Federal Communications Commission of the United States will also coordinate to release these resources. So now the main thing that American operators have in their hands is millimeter waves. Of course, they have also obtained some resources at 2.5 GHz from some operators. As for the European Union, the millimeter wave resources of the European Union have been clearly available for 5G use. Of course, they will also allocate some millimeter wave resources. China will have some available spectrum resources in the 2.6G, 3.3 to 3.6, including 4.8 to 5.0, including the millimeter wave band. Similarly, Japan and South Korea, they have some resources in the millimeter wave and C-band. So if we look at the global frequency situation, the first frequency is definitely the C-band. That is our 3.5G. It is currently very mature in the industry chain. There are also many products. Of course, if the C-band is not available, using 2.6G as the first band for EMBB scenarios is actually very valuable, because this band will be a bit lower, the coverage effect will be better. Of course, we can also improve the user experience through dual connections with 1.8G and 2.1G. Millimeter waves will become a supplement to our hotspot areas. Of course, it may not be used quickly at the beginning, but it will become an effective means of capacity supplementation in the future. All right. Let's take a look at the spectrum allocation situation in China. The Ministry of Industry and Information Technology has already clarified this year the spectrum allocation situation for 5G in China. China Telecom has obtained the 100 MHz band from 3.4G to 3.5G. Then China Unicom has obtained the 100 MHz spectrum resources from 3.5G to 3.6G China. Mobile has obtained 25,150 to 2,675. This 160 MHz of 2.6G spectrum resources for 5G use. Finally, mobile has 4.8 to 4.9. And another 100 MHz, so now mobile has 260 MHz of spectrum resources. Telecom and Unicom each have 100 MHz of spectrum resources, but we know that Telecom and Unicom have already started to share construction, wireless resource sharing. In the future, they may also consider sharing spectrum resources. This is the detailed division of our bandwidth. This is the current 4G spectrum plan. Let's mainly look at 5G China. Mobile has 160 MHz of spectrum resources at 2.6 GHz. Then Telecom has 100 MHz at 3.5G. Unicom has 100 MHz at 3.5G. Similarly, mobile has 100 MHz at 4.9G. Actually, we know that China now has the fourth telecom operator, that is the radio and television network. Radio and television has 4.9G to 4.4960. That is 60 MHz of 5G spectrum resources. But finally, at 4960 to 5000, we still have 40 megahertz of resources reserved for military use. Similarly, from 3.3 to 3.4, here we have 100 megahertz of resources. But these 100 megahertz of resources will be used for 5G indoor coverage. This is our current 5G band situation. Of course, we know that radio and television at 700 megahertz, there are also some resources at 700 megahertz. In the future, radio and television can consider using 700 megahertz for basic coverage. Then 4.9G to supplement some capacity. This is the current domestic situation, sub 6G mid-low frequency spectrum allocation situation. And then this 4.9G does some capacity supplementation. This is the current situation in the country, the allocation of this spectrum in the sub 6G mid-low frequency.